Welcome back to Spell and Math Tutorials. In today's clip, we're going to be working with the sides of a triangle, and given two sides, we're going to figure out what the length is of the, or the possible lengths of the third side. Before we continue, if you find this clip to be helpful, please remember to like, share, and or subscribe. Well, to figure out what the third side is, we take what's given. In this case, we see that we have a 12 and a 7. So let's go ahead and add those two lengths together. So here we have 12 plus 7, and we see that there gives us 19. The next simple calculation or operation we're going to do is subtraction. So now we're going to take those two lengths, 12, and then we're going to subtract off 7, and then we come up with 5. So here we have two boundaries, a boundary of 5 and 19. What we need to remember, though, is that the third length is never going to be 5, and it's never going to be 19. It has to fall between 5 and 19. I've created a model, so we're going to take a look at the model to visually show how this works. So here I have the triangle with a length, AC has a length of 12 units, and BA has a length of 7 units. And then here we have our variable length that I'm calling CB. Notice that as I move B, we see that B is approaching, well, as I move B, we see the variable length is increasing, and we see that it's approaching 19. But notice that as it's getting closer and closer and closer to 19, notice here that it never actually gets to 19. As I continue to circle around, we see that that length is now getting shorter, shorter, and shorter. We see it should be approaching 5, but it should never become 5. And as we go around, we see we get very close to 5, but it never actually is 5. All right, so that's the first one. Let's go ahead and move on to the second one. Again, the operations are very easy. We're going to add the two numbers together, then subtract them. So we're going to do 11 plus 6. And that there's going to give us 17. Then we're going to do 11 minus 6, and that gives us 5. So again, we have our boundaries between 5 and 17. So 5 has to be, so x is between the values of 5 and 17. Notice with my inequalities, there aren't any equal signs. I'm just using the less than signs here to show that that variable length has to be between 5 and 17, but that is not inclusive. And again, let's take a look at model. So here we come over. And we see the variable length here right now is at 7.3. We have the two fixed lengths, DE is at 6 and DF is at 11. As we rotate E around, we see that we're close to 5, very close to 5, but again, not 5. As we continue to rotate around, that variable length increases. It approaches 17. And here we see we're very close to 17, 16.99, but again, not 17. All right, let's move over and do the last example here. Here we have 8 and 9. Let's go ahead and add those two together. So here we have 8 plus 9, which gives us 17. And then we're going to do 9 minus 8, which gives us 1. So again, we have our boundaries of 1 and 17. So we see that 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 17. Again, the lengths will not be either 1 or 17. Has to fall between those two values. And let's look at this last model here. So here with the last model, again, let's move H. Well, we have the fixed lengths of IG at 9 and GH at 8, which was given. And now we're going to rotate this this vertex H around. It's currently at 14.5. We see it's increasing. It's going towards 17. But notice here that it will not be 17. 16.99, very close, but not 17. As we swing it around, it gets smaller and smaller and smaller. Notice that it should be approaching 1, but it should never actually be 1. And as we get closer and closer, we see that we're right there at 1.0053. So very close to 1, but again, not 1. All right, well, that sums up this tutorial by Spell and Math Tutorials. If you found this clip to be helpful, please share, like, and or subscribe. And as always, have a great day.